I, Edward Cullen, take you, Bella Swan.
For better or for worse.
To love.
To cherish. As long as we both shall live.
If the previous installments of the Twilight Saga weren't enough to slake the rampant thirst of breathless fans, there's still one more story to tell, even if it's in two parts.
I mean, it picks up with the wedding, the moment we've all been waiting for. The past three movies, everything's kind of been bottled up and nothing's really happened. And kind of at the beginning of this movie, we take the cork off and it just explodes. So now it's time for the wedding, it's time for the honeymoon.
Last night was the best night of my existence.
So Edwin and Bella kind of are probably at their strongest at the beginning of the movie. I mean, when she gets pregnant and Edward has no idea why, because he thinks it's some kind of demon baby, and then it's also quite clearly killing her as well.
It's impossible. Can this happen? Whoa.
Bella's pregnant. Is she going to survive? You know, is this thing that's growing inside of her going to kill her? And I think it's a very tense story. You get the answer to that story, and then the setup for everything that happens in the final movie.
For us, it wraps up really nice. Now for the fans, I think they will be very, very happy with it.
A publishing phenomenon has become a cinematic marvel and almost a way of life for the millions of twihards who have embraced both the novels and movies. 35mm looks at the past, present, and future of the saga with the people who are right in the eye of the hurricane.
It was my first American movie, and I sort of got it without really knowing what it was or what it was going to be. I was almost certain it wasn't going to be this.
Robert Pattinson is here tonight!
It's just got progressively more surreal every year. I mean, and to think that this premiere we had yesterday was bigger than all the other ones, I mean, it's just crazy.
What I love about my job is that I get to share why I love movies with actors and directors and writers that we work with.
So to share it with like that many people,
it's like a completely unique experience that no one gets to have. It's so rare. Whenever I'm asked, you know, so what advice would you like to give your fans, or what would you like to say to your fans? I never know, because it's like the common ground makes us so very much. The reason we love the story is because we share something. So I never know what to say, I just want to say hi.
I had no idea. I don't think anyone could see this coming at all.
It's impossible. Whoa.
The fetus isn't compatible with your body. It's too strong and fast growing.
It's crushing you from the inside out.
Your heart will give out before you can deliver. You did this.
I can't see Bella's future anymore.
We don't know what they bred. We have to protect the tribe before it's too late.
We went to Comic-Con in San Diego, and there was this huge auditorium with 6,000 fans.
I mean, literally no one had any idea who I was up until that point.
We walked into it and heard that scream for the first time.
They just put the word Twilight up, and everyone, it was the most deafening screams you've ever heard.
That was kind of the moment where we all looked at ourselves and were like, what are we getting ourselves into?
Get ready, they're coming for Bella.
You're not gonna touch her.
If you kill her, you kill me!
This movie will keep you on the edge of your seat until the very last second, and it will leave you wanting more, and that's what part two is for.
I'm curious what the reception will be for the very final one. I mean, it's going to be like 30,000 people at the premiere or something.